So it sounds like housing, there is discrimination. How about other things like movie theaters, restaurants?
Well, the restaurants, we didn't have much trouble with the restaurants, but then the movie theaters, we were always shunted upstairs. See, any theater that had an upstairs, right, they'd always ask us to leave and go upstairs. Now, I didn't notice that type of thing. I thought, well, upstairs is where the seats are. And so we just went up there as normally as it could be, except that on one occasion I didn't have any patience that day, and I thought, well, I'll go down to this Capitol Theater, and they have an upstairs. And I walked in, I got my ticket, and I walked into the lobby there, and I met this fellow that I went to school with, and he was working his way through medical school at the time. And I stopped and talked to him for a little while, and he directed me right to a seat down on the main floor. And another one of the ushers came up to him and says, "You can't let him sit down here. He's got to go upstairs." Well, there was hardly anybody in the theater. It was a very, in fact, if I'd have gone upstairs, I'd probably been the only person upstairs. But then I could overhear him say, "You can't let him sit down here." And he says, "Well, I know him. He's a friend of mine. And I went to school with him, went to high school with him." He says, "I can't go down and tell him to go upstairs." And so and I could overhear their conversation. He says, "Well, the next time any of these Japs or colored, you send them upstairs." See? And that's when I first realized that all the so-called coloreds were directed upstairs.